Hello guys, in this video I'm going to do some work on this Fujitsu Siemens P5600 computer with a Fujitsu Siemens monitor, Romanian keyboard, mouse, webcam. This has also built-in speakers, and we have their GPU that I already took out of this thing and had it in my PC for 1 or 2 or 3 months, but had some issues with Windows 10, maybe because of the drivers, or maybe my Windows 10 install, which is about 1.5, almost 2 years old, maybe had some issues by itself. I don't know. I'm going to try and put it back in this thing, and then again put Windows 10, install the drivers and see if everything works correctly. And next you will see the moment I take that card out, and then we will continue in the present moment. Okay, to tell you the story, I don't know, about 10 years ago or something like that, maybe a bit more, this thing was my computer, my rig. I gave it to my parents, and then from my parents we gave it to my aunt, and it was in use up until 2 or 3 weeks when I gave my aunt an HP all-in-one 200 computer, which actually broke down and I needed to fix, but that is a whole other video. Don't buy all-in-one computers. If you are watching this and you are thinking, do not buy all-in-one computers, really hard to fix and expensive. Okay, so this thing still working, it's ancient but really well built, needs to get a clean, and I will put Windows 10 on it. I have a keyboard, mouse, monitor, I will attach them all, but the first thing I need to take out the GPU from this thing, because maybe if you've seen another one of my videos, I'm actually selling my GPU. I'm trying to profit a little bit from the high prices of the GPUs at the moment, but my computer has a motherboard without an integrated GPU, so I need something to put in my computer so I can still use it. Yeah, it is coming out. I have no idea how much dust will be in here, but probably a lot. Yeah, less than I expected. But in here there is a ton of dust. This thing probably hasn't been opened up in 5-6 years. Something like that. So, yeah, let's try and get the GPU out and see what we are dealing with. And as you might actually see, dust is falling out. This thing has an integrated GPU, but I will still put in it another weaker GPU, I think, because I do have another system, but that I will be working on, and I will put also that link in this video. But that one has a rather weird GPU that I modded. I changed the heatsink with a homemade heatsink, if you can believe it. In that period I was doing all sorts of really crazy mods. Okay, we have a ton of dust, so I need to clean this before I put it in my system. Yeah, on that thing I modded the GPU heavily, modded the BIOS, so that will be going into this thing, and that one will remain with the integrated GPU. We have here, but I will show you a little bit better, an SSD that I made myself. I think it's a PCIe, let me show you, an SSD similar to this Wi-Fi card in size, in an adapter, and with the adapter together they are put in an I don't know, tape enclosure from those old times when people were still using cassette tapes or whatever, videotapes. So I will be showing you that when I clean this thing, but for the moment I need to clean this GPU and show it to you after it's cleaned. Okay, so this thing really does need a clean. It's a bit stuck. It hasn't been opened up in a while. Whoa! So this is dirty as hell. I'm going to do some high speed cleaning. It will probably not be 100% perfect because I have a little newborn baby girl in the house and I don't really want to get any of this dust outside. So normally you would also want to blow a little bit of it, not only use a vacuum, but I'm just going to use a vacuum and brushes. Hopefully that is enough. So let's get to some high speed cleaning. Okay, it's cleaned inside, not perfect again, but I don't have the possibility to do perfect at this time, but way better than what it was. It has two sticks of 1 GB of memory, so 2 GB, and I am going to add these two sticks. This is a 512 MB and a 256 MB stick. Yes, you will say not ideal, they are different capacities, problems with dual channel. Well, let me just tell you, dual channel is only real and has real performance benefits in really intensive, memory intensive apps. So just for normal programs, everyday web browsing, whatever, it's better to have more memory instead of lower amount of memory with better dual channel support. And I'm thinking this will actually run in dual channel, but asymmetrical dual channel, so not all of the memory will be in dual channel, but just the main part of it. So don't really care. Moving the camera, it's really tight around here. I have a lot of things around me. Better to have 2.75 gigabytes then only 2 GB for Windows 10 32-bit that I'm going to put on this thing. So this will go in next, then we will put back in the PSU. Back in the day I upgraded this heatsink. As you can see, it's bent right here because this wasn't fitting proper over it, and it held up really nicely. Next I'm also going to put in the GPU, and just wanted to show you something else. I don't know really how to take this out of the way, maybe like this somehow. Yeah, it's out of the way. Let's remove these two cables right here. You see this weird little thing right here? I don't know, for some of you which are a bit older, it's not 100% clear. My tripod will squeak now, so yeah. Let me zoom on it. This is something that I built myself. You can see glue right here, 7-8 years ago, who knows. So I bought a 32 gigabytes PCI, mini PCI SSD. It was from an Asus EEPC or something like that, really cheap from somebody. Then I bought an adapter from mini PCI to SATA, which is the green one that you see here, the SSD is inside, and put everything inside a tape, a plastic case. So this is a videotape case modified by me to be transformed into some kind of SSD, so I can put with double-sided tape into this PC, which was given to me to my aunt and uncle at that time. And this SSD was a gift, because this was going really slow when my uncle was web browsing, but this SSD has held up without trim on Windows XP for about, like I said, 6-7 years of use. So thumbs up for that. And this was stick glued to it. This was had glue on the other side, it fell down over time. Christmas in September, 32 gigabyte SSD. I gave this SSD, the whole computer, a few years ago, and then the SSD next, because it was running really slow, but I didn't want to wait for Christmas, so I gave it to them in September as a Christmas present. Yeah, and this is why it had this thing glued to it. Yeah, so that's about it for stories. I'm going to keep this as a memory. And I'm going to put everything back now and try to put Windows 10 on it and see how it runs. The GPU that will be going in, it's an HD 4670 512 megabyte card. Not the most powerful one, but will do the job at the level of this dual core AMD PC from back in the day. Okay, everything is connected. We have power. Let's give it a bell. F2 to enter the BIOS. Ta-da! And we are inside the BIOS. And yeah, we can see the memory, 2814 megabytes. We can see here the SSD. Let me try and zoom just a tiny bit of it on it. SSD here, hard drive, it's 160 gig. Right there, SSD 32 gig. We will put Windows 10 32 bit on that thing. Hopefully it's enough. And yeah, I will tinker a little bit with the BIOS, and then we will start installing Windows 10. Okay. Just booted from the USB drive. This is the Windows 10 install starting up. I will do all the usual settings, obviously, and hopefully we will have a Windows 10 working on this thing. Or actually, wait, what? No, sorry, no, my bad, error. This should have Windows 10 on it. Why doesn't it have Windows 10? Oh man, yeah. I totally forgot that actually I put Windows 7 at one point on this thing. Why would I do that? Yeah, need to search for another USB drive. Sorry, error. You know it. I'm doing this the old school style with optical drives. Woohoo! This will take longer. It will be a little bit boring for me, but I will have the sound of optical drives. So reboot or whatever, shut down. What? Why don't you hate I hate brand computers. They don't reboot when you want them to. They just reboot when they want to reboot. Press F12. Any day now. CD-ROM drive. And do we have liftoff? Optical drive spinning up, something, whatever, anything. If you are young enough, you do not know the pain of waiting for an optical drive to read. And this is the Windows 10 logo. Should have known the other one was Windows 7. So get back to you in a moment. Okay, I have a few options of Windows 10. Obviously, I will use x86 and not the 64-bit version. S is more for education from what I know. I need Windows 10 Home, so the install itself is as small as possible. And I'm going to use Windows 10 Home N because it doesn't install media players and stuff like that. And that is perfect for me because I am going to install my personal preferred programs for media. So I save up space. So Windows 10 Home N trial will be installed. Okay, here are the available drives. This is the SSD and this is where we will install Windows. So we create a partition on it. Obviously it's creating also its system reserve partition and the full partition for the hard drive itself. And this is the one where we want to install Windows. And it's going to do it right now. So the install went really, really fast, even on an older computer. Having an SSD is a huge bonus. So guys, if you have an old computer that you like, put an SSD in it. It's really important. Now I will just do a few startup settings and then hopefully we have a running Windows 10. Okay, so the drivers for the GPU are downloading by themselves now. I'm not even going to try and install the control center for the ATI graphics card. I'm just going to let the basic drivers for this GPU install by themselves from Windows 10. And we just got an error. I don't really like this. Let's see what happened here. Okay, take two. You can see here 2.75 gigabytes of memory, an Athlon 64X2 dual core 2 gigahertz CPU. Just wanted to show you we have 20 gigabytes free of 29 gigabytes of the SSD because 29 gigabytes is the formatted size. So Windows 10 Home N version is using 9 gigabytes itself, which is decent. So you can run this thing out of a 32 gigabytes SSD. So let's close this. CPU, not really doing a lot at this point. One drive got installed once again, so I need to get rid of it, make sure it doesn't start with Windows. And some kind of quit OneDrive close. Yeah, I want to get rid of it. Sound manager again, want to not show the icon in the system tray. And we have sound from this monitor. Which is decent. It's good. So we have video, audio, whatever, network. This computer has everything that it actually needs. And let's do another run on the video driver. The only driver that it's missing actually, it's the video. It's just the basic Windows driver at the moment. And the webcam driver, which I'm not really sure if we will be able to find, but I will for sure try. So update driver automatically. And hopefully we don't get a blue screen this time and it actually works, but remains to be seen. Nope, we do actually get another blue screen, exactly the same as we did before. So yeah, I need to force it to install another driver that I already have downloaded on my computer from when I had the discard on Windows 10. And I will use a weird method to install a legacy driver. I will show you in a moment. While I am going to search for that driver on my computer, I'm using NiniT to install all my usual software, and then I will install the driver myself. Just wanted to add another thing that supports the SSD. You can see here, it's almost never at 100%. So the bottleneck in this system is 100% the CPU itself. In a lot of older computers that I work on, when installing Windows, other programs and stuff like this, the hard drive is always the bottleneck and the CPU is just staying there. So when you have a hard drive bottleneck, if you put in an SSD, you will maximize everything that that particular computer can actually give you without changing the CPU or CPU and motherboard, whatever, bigger upgrades. But with that particular CPU, put an SSD in. You can see only now we have reached 100%. And what is it doing? It's installing Avira, which I know for a fact that it's using a lot of resources. And that was about it for 100. We are dropping, and now again like 100, but it's not just 100 and staying there like I seen a lot of older computers. So put in an SSD, guys. And we have here the legacy driver, so hopefully after everything finish I will give it a restart and put that driver. Okay, so to install the legacy driver, which is this version, in this case it's 13.9, 32 bits, you need to troubleshoot compatibility, select Windows 8, click next, and obviously you need to test the program because it will not let you finish any other way, and it should actually work. Hopefully, at least on my main rig, this actually worked. But here, it doesn't seem to be doing anything. But in all honesty, I actually installed the 64-bit version on that thing. And I actually see the 32-bit version doesn't even specify Windows 8, so... Not really sure what's up with that. I will just tinker a little bit. Or, well, actually it did, but it was in the background. So, let's see. Install. Hopefully it will work. So, high speed video continues. Okay guys, so didn't really manage to install the driver for the GPU yet. But if you can believe it, I managed to install the driver for the webcam. A driver that was made for Windows XP, and I found it on a forum from about 2006, so 12 years ago, and this driver is still working on Windows 10. But ATI/AMD were unable to make a driver that would properly work on Windows 10 for a GPU way newer than this webcam. And Nvidia cards, I've worked with a lot of them on Windows 10, all of them worked perfectly. So yeah, ATI/AMD, crappy driver support compared to Nvidia, sadly. Yeah, I always like to support the underdog, but in this situation they just don't support their products enough. Look at this thing, with an XP driver it's working perfectly, and I am unable to install that GPU driver. I was able to install it again on my main rig with a 64-bit OS, but it was creating problems for me, and I'm 100% sure now that it was because of the driver and not because my Windows 10 install was old. So I don't know, I'm going to tinker with it a little bit more. If I can't do anything, I'm going to let it run with the default basic display driver from Windows 10, and yeah, basically that's it, nothing else that I can do. No support means no support. And every single thread that I can find on forums online fixing that particular blue screen that I actually get when I try to install the drivers ends up in updating, I don't know, BIOS or whatever. A thing that obviously I'm unable to do on this system because it's rather old. So probably it's some kind of combination between an old system and that card that is not properly supported in Windows 10. And in my rig, I was just lucky that my particular system was really new, so somehow the driver partially worked, but it wasn't good also there, but here it's not working at all. So yeah, thank you AMD, way to go. Not okay. So I decided to do the most sensible thing and put another GPU in here. Obviously this is a weaker card and it's missing one screw. Yeah, I need to fix that. This is an NVIDIA 7200 GS, 256 megs only, but for this particular CPU this is a good match. And this one, honestly, for the workstation from which I just took this card, the workstation I just bought recently from eBay, didn't have time to work on it, and it will have 48 gigs of RAM, Xeon CPU. So this card was way underpowered. Even the one in this one is a little bit underpowered for that thing, even though it will not be used for gaming. So the thing will obviously have 64-bit Windows 10, so this GPU that's in this thing now will probably work on that thing at least partially, like it did on my computer. But on my computer the main problem was Windows Movie Maker wasn't running properly on this card. But I think I'm the only one left in this whole world that still uses Windows Movie Maker, so that will be no problem for anybody. So that card will be going in the workstation, and this card from the workstation will be going in this, and hopefully Windows 10 will install a proper driver for it and no problems will occur. I could try and lose 1, 2, 3 days and make this card work in this particular system, this ATI card, but no. I've learned that sometimes you just need to give up and not waste your time if it's not worth it. While this is shutting down, I just forgot to tell you that particular workstation that I just took this card from arrived with these four heavy memory DIMMs loose inside the case and flying all around. So they probably knocked into this GPU at least a few times. So this could actually not be working if any of the tiny components got hit and knocked off. So yeah, we will see what we get, but I will try anyway. What the actual hell? Who assembled this card? What did they do here? It was only in half of the pins. I hope I didn't burn anything by plugging it in. But how can you actually do something like that so stupid? Okay, so this is the red wire. Hopefully you can see its edge red there. And the tiny arrow there on the board. So this goes in here like this. Who did that? How did they do that? So this board might hopefully still be working. And I see here a collision mark. Maybe you can see this scratch, but luckily there was no component to be knocked off right there. You can see even on the solder pad a big dent in there, but should be still working. But this thing, what the hell? What did they do? I don't know. I don't think it was assembled like that. I think somebody worked on it or something, and they are just not really bright, I could say, because I can't understand how in any other way you could do something like that. Hopefully now it works, but we will see in a moment. Okay, so Windows couldn't find the driver automatically. I went to the Nvidia website, downloaded it, installed it perfectly. It was normally designed for Windows 8, not a problem running on Windows 10. Yeah, and that's about it, drama free. So yeah, Nvidia can do it, AMD try to do it also. We have 15 gigabytes free of 29.2 gigabytes. I'm thinking this is enough, and anything else can be installed on the other hard drive if actually needed. And yeah, that's about it. We actually at this point have Nvidia control panel and AMD Vision control center, because this is an AMD CPU, and this is able to set up a few things for this particular CPU, so I will still leave it installed. And everything seems to be running just perfect on this thing, which benefits a lot from the fact that we actually have an SSD inside of it. So we did it. Windows 10 running perfectly, hardware running perfectly, and this thing will be going in a system with Windows 10 64-bit, and hopefully without any more drama. And yeah, that's about it guys for this video. Thank you for watching. Ask whatever you need and say whatever you want in the comments. As always, check out my other videos, subscribe to my channel, and see you in the next one. Bye!